Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss one of the new drugs to control the calcium, Cinacalcet. What is this drug Cinacalcet? This drug is classified as calcium sensing receptor agonist. Simply to put, Cinacalcet acts as calcimimetic agent. So this drug acts as a calcium. It can bind to one of the receptors which are highly sensitive to the calcium. These receptors are called as calcium sensing receptors. Now Cinacalcet can bind to these receptors as agonist, which increases even binding of low levels of ionized calcium to these receptors. So Cinacalcet is a calcimimetic agent which increases the calcium signaling, thereby it can control the levels of parathyroid hormone. That's why this drug can be used in the conditions like secondary hyperparathyroidism. The term secondary indicates that the hyperparathyroidism is associated because of any other effects which results in the enlargement of parathyroid gland. Among the so many risk factors, renal system play an important role to induce secondary hyperparathyroidism. The inactive form of vitamin D is going to be activated within the kidneys. And this active form of vitamin D is responsible for absorption of calcium from the food. Now, due to the active form of vitamin D, calcium can be absorbed into the intestine, which is responsible for various cellular activities. But in patients with chronic kidney disease or patients with end-stage renal failure, the renal functionality is significantly reduced, which results in reduced activation of vitamin D. Since vitamin D is not activated, it cannot increase the absorption of calcium into the intestine, which results in decreased serum calcium levels. When the calcium levels are decreased, it stimulates the parathyroid gland, resulting in hyperparathyroidism. So this results in the increased secretion of PTH. In such conditions, the raised levels of parathyroid hormone can produce various systemic complications. Therefore, it should be thoroughly controlled. So in such situations, Cinacalcet can be used to control the raised levels of PTH. Apart from this clinical indication, Cinacalcet can also be used in the conditions like parathyroid carcinoma. This is a condition where the cancerous growth results in the raised levels of PTH, again leading to systemic complications. Since calcium can control the secretion of PTH from parathyroid gland, Cinacalcet can be used as a calcimimetic agent which reduces the secretion of PTH. Similarly, in few of the conditions, the calcium levels are excessively raised, resulting in hypercalcemia. This hypercalcemia may be associated with primary hyperparathyroidism. Again, in such situations, Cinacalcet can be used, but it is not a first-line drug in the treatment of primary hyperparathyroidism. In those patients where surgery to remove the parathyroid gland is not suggestible, in such patients, Cinacalcet can be used to reduce the growth of parathyroid gland. So today in this video, let us discuss what are the important precautions, side effects of this drug, how this drug acts, how this drug is going to be given. All these things we will discuss in this video. First of all, let us see how this drug acts. On the chief cells of parathyroid gland, calcium sensitive receptors are present. These are the G protein coupled receptors and they are coupled with alpha beta gamma subunits. The ionized calcium can bind to these receptors. But when this calcium is at low concentration, it cannot significantly stimulate these receptors. In such situations, we can use one of the drug, Cinacalcet. Cinacalcet acts as a calcimimetic agent. It can bind to calcium sensing receptors, which improves the binding of calcium to these receptors, leading to their activation. So when these receptors are activated, they can stimulate phospholipase C system so that phosphatidyl inositol biphosphate can be split into two fragments. One is IP3 and second one is DAG, diacyl glycerol. This IP3 can release the intracellular calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Now IP3 can bind to the IP3 receptors, which results in the release of intracellular calcium. Similarly, DAG can interact with phospholipids so that it can activate one of the key enzyme, protein kinase C. This protein kinase C can then increase the expression of inward coming calcium channels through which calcium can enter into the cytoplasm. In this way, the intracellular calcium levels are increased by the action of cinacalcet. Quite opposite to many of the cells, the raised levels of calcium within the chief cells will show opposite effect on release of mediators. So the raised levels of calcium can inhibit the release of parathyroid hormone so that it is not significantly secreted, resulting in the decreased PTH levels, thereby it can improve the symptoms of hyperparathyroidism. In this way, cinacalcet can increase the calcium signaling, thereby it can reduce the secretion of PTH. Now let us the precautions of this drug. One of the important precautions of cinacalcet is that since this drug is going to control the calcium levels, use of this drug may result in hypocalcemia, the decreased calcium levels. By use of this drug, the calcium levels may be reduced less than 8.4 milligrams per deciliter. When the calcium levels fall at this level, this drug can produce few of the symptoms such as paresthesia, loss of sensation, myalgia, muscle pains as well as muscle cramps. It can also induce the risk of convulsions because of decreased serum calcium levels. So care should be taken when the cinacalcet is used to control the hypocalcemia, and sometimes we can observe calcium levels are falling in between 7.5 to 8.4 milligrams per deciliter, where we can observe the symptoms like paresthesias, muscle pains and muscle cramps. In such conditions, vitamin D supplement should be given in order to restore the calcium levels as well as to reduce the risk of convulsions. So with the use of cinacalcet, the calcium level should be regularly checked in order to prevent hypocalcemia and its complications. Sometimes with use of cinacalcet, the calcium levels may fall less than 7.5 milligrams per deciliter, which is a fatal condition. That's why in such situations, the use of cinacalcet is not recommended. So when the calcium levels fall less than 7.5 milligrams per deciliter, this drug should not be continued. This drug can reduce the calcium levels. Because of reduced calcium levels, it can modulate the neuronal activity. So cinacalcet can reduce the threshold potential for induction of seizures. When this threshold potential is reduced, even a small stimuli can induce the seizures in the patients. So again, care should be taken with use of cinacalcet, as this drug can increase the risk of seizures by reducing threshold potential. Similarly, this drug should be carefully given in the patients with any heart failure, as well as this drug can increase the risk of heart failure in susceptible patients. Due to development of heart failure, it can induce either hypotension in the patients, otherwise it can produce some cardiac arrhythmias. So all these points should be considered with high dose of cinacalcet. Since this drug is going to reduce the parathyroid hormone levels, the intact levels of PTH should be checked. With high dose of cinacalcet, the intact PTH levels, IPTH levels are going to be reduced, which may result in development of adynamic bone disease, commonly known as ABD. This is a condition where the turnover of bone is going to be reduced because of reduced bone formation and resorption due to decreased levels of intact parathyroid hormone levels. And many of the times, this ABD is associated with other risk factors such as chronic kidney disease. So in such patients, we can observe low bone turnover, decreased osteoclast as well as osteoblast activities, which again reduce the bone turnover and bone formation. So care should be taken when this cinacalcet is used at high dose, and the intact PTH level should be thoroughly checked in order to avoid adynamic bone disease. When these IPTH levels are less than 100 milligrams per deciliter, the risk of adynamic bone disease is going to be increased. Now let us see the side effects of this drug. The important side effects mainly include nausea. This drug can produce nausea and vomiting as one of the important side effects. And it can produce some diarrhea, even it can produce some constipation and abdominal pain. Dizziness is another important side effect that can be observed with cinacalcet. It can also produce some muscle pain, muscle cramps, asthenia, lack of energy can be observed, and it can also increase the risk of seizures, by reducing the threshold potential. Other side effects mainly include abdominal pain, loss of appetite, and dehydration can be observed with this Cinacalcet. How it is given? This drug is available as a tablet at a strength of 30 mg, 60 mg and 90 mg. The initial dose is started at low dose such as 30 mg given once daily. The dose can be increased based on the estimation of IPTH levels. After 2 to 4 weeks of the treatment, the dose can be increased to 60 mg once daily. And slow drug increments can be done up to maximum dose of 180 mg, again given once daily. But at higher doses, there is a high risk of development of hypocalcemia, induction of seizures, and development of adynamic bone disease. So all these points should be kept in mind when this drug is used at high doses. So that's all about this drug, Cinacalcet, which is a calcimimetic agent. This drug increases the sensitivity of calcium towards the calcium-sensing receptors, which are expressed on the chief cells of parathyroid gland. By use of this drug, even low levels of calcium can bind to these receptors, resulting in activation of phospholipase C system, which results in the increased intracellular calcium levels that inhibits the secretion of parathyroid hormone. In this way, this drug reduces the parathyroid hormone levels, thereby it reduces the systemic complications associated with hyperparathyroidism. Hypocalcemia, risk of seizures, and adynamic bone disease are the important precautions with this drug. And this drug is started at low dose such as 30 mg given once daily. After 2 to 4 weeks of the treatment, the dose increments can be done to a maximum dose of 180 mg per day. So that's all about this drug, Cinacalcet. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.